So what was the surprising thing or the strange thing that happened? Yes, the servants, they packed their belongings and they had decided to leave. Why were they doing that? What were they upset about? Yes? 12B? What were they upset about, Malik? Why did the servants decide to leave? They were not happy with the, you can say what, with Dr. Sadao and Hana keeping the man for so long, right? One, they've given him shelter. Second, they've performed the surgery. And now they're still there in their home. And so they're worried about their safety, okay? And yes, what were the servants discussing among themselves? The gardener and the other servants, what were they discussing? That why is Sadao behaving like this? Why is Hana behaving like this? Now they have been in America and they have started thinking like the Americans, or they like the Americans. That is why they have saved the life of an American. Okay. So the servants, they were not happy. And what did Yumi tell Hana before she left? Yes. What did she say? Gitesh, come over here. Come on the first bench. Who's there in the last one? Shivam, do you have the book? Show me a book. Come here on the first bench. Come here where I can see you. Come on, come here. I don't want you to be so comfortable over there. Come over here on the first bench. You also, Gitesh, move forward. Who's talking over there? Silence, please. So, yes, here, Yumi told Hana that if the kids, you know, they are not comfortable, or if you have any problem, you can call me. But Hana did not even say one thing at all. When the servants were about to leave, she gave them the salary, right? And so she was very calm and dignified and in a very respectful manner. She never even said that, don't go. How will I manage without you, right? Shows that, yes, so she has decided to be very strong. And she is supporting what Dr. Sadao is doing, because if he has saved the life of the soldier, she thinks that, yes, it would be the right thing to be done under such a situation. The servants, they think otherwise. So what have they decided to do? They have decided to leave. Now, on the same day, Sadao did something else. That was, you have to remember, he wrote a letter to the chief of the police, describing the events that happened and how he saw that man on the shore, how he has brought him home. He started writing the letter, but he did not complete it. And why was he writing this letter? Just to be on this, you know, like the safer side, to inform the authorities about this incident that had happened, right? So he has realized that, yeah, the servants have left and it could be quite possible there's a risk to his family. The servants might go and complain, then what? Right? Although they are very trustworthy, they're very faithful. They have been there with him for long. Okay? Yes, all of you come on page 38. What about the soldier? Can you tell me about him? Has he started feeling better? Yes. He started talking. Is Sadao listening to him? Is Sadao interested? No. What does the prisoner say his name was? Tom, right? So he's told his name, right? Open to page 39 now. Yes, so here, okay, page 38, let's do the first last paragraph again. Sadao did not answer, but a little later he went into the room where the prisoner was and said brusquely, "Today you may get up on your feet. I want you to stay up only 5 minutes at a time. Tomorrow you may try it twice as long. It would be well that you get your strength back as quickly as possible." Now the servants have left and Hana is there wondering. The servants can see better. They can think better than us. They realize the danger of the situation. Why is Sadao not understanding, right? So when, yes, so Sadao is quite worried. He is worried about the safety of his family. And that is why he's a little rude with the soldier, okay, brusquely, in a rough way he's talking to him. He saw the flicker of terror on the young face that was still very pale. Someone is still talking. That's not nice at all. So what did he notice? A flicker of terror. What is the man afraid of? He said, you can be on your feet, you can walk again, you'll get your strength back, and once the man is better, he can leave. Why is there terror on his face? What had happened? Shivam, can you open your book? You fail in English and nothing else can happen then. So what? Not in English. Yes, why is that terror on his face? On the soldier's face, on the prisoner's face. Why? What is he scared of? Why doesn't he want to leave this place? What had happened to him? What had happened to him? He had been caught by the enemy. He had escaped. So that terror once again, that what will happen if he is outside, right? And what the, you can say, maybe remembering what had happened to him. Okay, the boy murmured. Evidently, he was determined to say more. I feel I ought to thank you, doctor, for having saved my life. Don't thank me too early. Sadao said coldly. He saw the flicker of terror again in the boy's eyes. So something must have happened that is, you know, like really scared him. Terror as unmistakable as an animal's. The scars on his neck were crimson for a moment. Crimson, red, bright red. And who had noticed these scars? Varun, stand up. Who had noticed these scars? Sadao had noticed or Hana had noticed? And when she saw those scars, what did she think of? What did she think those scars were? Signs of torture, okay? Yes, Varun, you can't even give one answer. You don't read the chapter? You don't listen only? Your name is Varun? So, right, and yes, when Hana saw those scars, she was worried or she was thinking about the torture. She had heard the stories about torture. Yes, which general stories had she heard about? General Takima, right? And when he would go there, he was very victorious. He was very powerful. What else had she heard about him? That he would beat his wife, right? Now he's seen the scars on the young man's neck, and it's a reminder that maybe those stories that they have heard about the prisoners being tortured, they are true. Okay, so once again here, what is there? Those scars are very, very clearly visible. Those scars, what were they? Sadao did not ask because he felt that he knew what those scars were. In the afternoon, the second thing happened. Already so many things have happened. One was the servants leaving. Now what else is going to happen? Let's see. Hana working hard on unaccustomed labor. What does this mean? What is so different in Hana's routine that day? Why is she working so hard? Why is she so busy? Because the servants had left. So she's having a very busy schedule, right? So unaccustomed labor. She's not used to, you know, like so much of work. But today is a different day. She saw a messenger come to the door in official uniform. The messenger in uniform. It's very important now. Please look at this carefully. Her hands went weak and she could not draw her breath. Why did Hana become so afraid when she saw that official and that too in uniform? What is she afraid of? That's correct. Yeah, maybe the servants have told. Maybe this official has come to know that, there is a white man in their house. So that is why she's scared. The servants must have told already. So this is the fear in her mind. She ran to Sadao, gasping, unable to utter a word. But by then, the messenger had simply followed her through the garden and there he stood. She pointed at him helplessly. So she could not do anything. The man is already inside the house. She did not have time to warn Sadao. Sadao looked up from his book. He was in his office. The other partition of which was thrown open to the garden for the southern sunshine. So he's there doing his work. What is it? He asked the messenger, and then he rose, seeing the man's uniform. You are to come to the place, palace, sorry, the man said. The old general is in pain again. Who is old general? Who's the general? Yeah, why wasn't Sadao sent to war? Yes, so the general would need a surgery anytime. He's not well, and there's only one surgeon that he trusted, and that was Sadao. What was the other thing that Sadao was working on? Yes, wounds, right? Heal faster. Very nice. Very good. Someone is still talking, and that someone happens to be Varun. Keep quiet. So the general here, I've just mentioned the name of a general. General Takima. Okay? Yes. So the old general is in pain again. Oh, Hana, breathe. Is that all? Why is that all? What was she expecting? That the soldier would have come to arrest her now? So is she relieved now? Yes, a big sigh of relief. All, the messenger exclaimed, and the messenger is surprised. All, the general is not well. What more do you need? Right? So he's not aware of the, you can say, what that fear that was there in Hana's mind. Is it not enough? Indeed it is, she replied. I'm very sorry. In a way, she's very relieved also. Right? Okay. I'm sorry about the condition of the general. When Sadao came to say goodbye, she was in the kitchen but doing nothing. The children were asleep, and she sat merely resting for a moment, more exhausted from her fright than from work. What was the fright that she got? What was the fright that Hana got? Fright means? What does fright mean? Fear? So what was the fright that Hana got? She saw the messenger coming, right? The messenger in official uniform. Get up, Varun. Come here on the first bench. Come here. Come here. I thought they had come to arrest you, she said. He gazed down into her anxious eyes. I must get rid of this man for your sake, he said in distress. Somehow I must get rid of him. This man, which man are they referring to? The American. And now why is Sadao thinking of getting rid of him? He saved his life. The man is better. Now why does he want to get rid of him? Why does he want to get rid of the man? Yes? I can't hear anything. Yes, because it's not that he's more worried about his family's safety, right? Looking at Hana so scared. So he does not want her to be scared. Now Sadao goes to the general. Of course, the general said weakly, I understand fully, but that is because I once took a degree in Princeton. So few Japanese have. So now Sadao is there talking to the general. And we assume he has told him about the prisoner. And the general says, I have also taken a degree from Princeton. That means he has also been abroad. He has also been to America, right? I care nothing for the man, Excellency, Sadao said. But having operated on him with such success, I don't care about the man. Which man? The white man. But I operated on him and successfully I was able to save him. So he's discussing this with the general. Yes, yes, the general said. It only makes me feel you more indispensable to me. What does indispensable mean? Look at your book. Indispensable. Write down meanings. Write down here. It is an objective test. You can get any kind of question. Indispensable, unable to do without. Something that is very, very important. Okay? Right. So why does he say that you are now even more indispensable? You're very important now. I can't do without you. I need you for my surgery. Because see, you were able to save the life of the wounded
soldier,
right? Indispensable to me. Evidently, you can save anyone. You are so skilled. You say you think I can stand one more such attack as I have had today. So what had happened to the general? He was not well, right? And now Sadao has gone to meet him. And Sadao has told him about the soldier. So why did he do so? Why do you think Sadao told him about him? To save himself and to save his family. To not to be called a traitor. Not to be taken away by the police, right? Not more than one. So you've had one attack, you can't tolerate another one. Then certainly I can allow nothing to happen to you. That means if I can't survive here, I am in such a, you can say, serious health issues, nothing should happen to you. The general said with anxiety, his long, pale Japanese face became expressionless, which meant that he was in deep thought. You cannot be arrested, the general said, closing his eyes. Suppose you were condemned to death and the next day I had to have my operation. What quality does it show about the general? Is he selfish? He's not selfish. He is selfish. He's more concerned about his health. That you can't go now. I can't let you go. Right? Is he saving Sadao because he's a good surgeon or a good human being? More so he's saving Sadao because he cannot survive without him. Right? So yes, so quite selfish. The next day I had to have my operation. There are other surgeons, Excellency, Sadao suggested. None I trust, the general replied. The best ones have been trained by Germans and would consider the operation successful even if I died. I do not care for their point of view. How can operation be successful if a person has died? German's point of view, which the general does not like, yes? He's saying like you've been trained in America, right? Sadao had been trained in America. There are other surgeons, some of them have got the training in Germany. And what is the German's point of view when it comes to surgery? This is one important aspect that he's saying, that here they are not going to think about saving the life. They want that the operation should be successful. I want that I should survive, right? Which is more important. So that is why he's not very happy with the German point of view. It seems a pity that we cannot combine the German ruthlessness with the American sentimentality. Boy, he wants the best of both things. Americans are sentimental also when they perform the surgery, but Germans are ruthless, heartless, careless. They are concerned about the surgery, whether the patient survives or not. Americans, they try their best to save the patient also, right? That is why he wants Sadao, because what kind of a training has he had? An American training, which is beneficial for him. So sentiments, yeah, they are there concerned about the patient also. So which do you think is a better point of view, the German or the American? American, definitely. Then you could turn your prisoner over to execution, and yet I could be sure you would not murder me while I was unconscious. So he said, fine, I want you to be here with me when I have my surgery, and I can hand, like you can hand your prisoner over, right, to the police or to the officials, and I know you will not murder me even if I am Ankita. The general laughed. He had an unusual sense of humor. As a Japanese, could you not combine these two foreign elements? See, the Germans are very professional. Americans are sentimental also. So he says, can't you combine both these things? So it would be better to, nice to have a doctor who has those two elements. So Sadao smiled. I am not quite sure, but for your sake, I would be willing to try, Excellency. The general shook his head. Why is he referring to him as Excellency? because he's a general, correct? And of course, general is a quite a high post, right? The highest rather. I had rather not be the test case, he said. He felt suddenly weak. What do you want, Pratap? And overwhelmed with the cares of his life as an official in times such as these, when reported victory brought great responsibilities all over the South Pacific. It is very unfortunate that this man should have washed up on your doorstep. So he's saying, yes, it is quite an unfortunate incident that this man is there right in front of your house. He had to come. Which man are we talking about? Which man? The white man, the American. I feel it so myself, Saddam said gently. It would be best if he could be quietly killed. The general said, not by you, but by someone who does not know him. Read this paragraph quietly, Malik. You can do your discussion later. Not by you, but by someone who does not know him. I have my own private assassins. Suppose I send two of them to your house tonight, or better, any night. You need know nothing about it. It is now warm. What would be more natural than that you should leave the outer partition of the white man's room open to the garden while he sleeps? Right, so the general has given an idea, Harsimarpreet. Which idea has the general given? Whose assassins? So the general he has is private, you know, assassins. He's a very powerful person. And he has that much of power and authority, maybe, yes, to eliminate people whom he thinks are a threat. So he's saying, I can send my assassins, and what can they do? They can, what does assassin mean? To kill. Yes. So they can come and kill the man, and they'll even take his body away. So no one will know what has happened. What you have to do is just keep the partition open. So it's quite warm. It's okay if you keep the partition open. Certainly, it would be very natural. In fact, it is so left open every night. Good, the general said, yawning. There are very capable assassins. They make no noise and they know the trick of inward bleeding. So there'll be no traces of blood even. Right? He'll bleed inwardly only. If you like, I can even have them remove the body. So the whole plan is made. What is going to happen to the soldier? What is the general going to do? He's going to kill. And of course, yes, they know the trick where no traces of blood would be there. And they would also take away the dead body. So this is a good enough plan. So now considered that perhaps would be best, Excellency. He agreed, thinking of Hana. He's worried about the safety of his family. So even if it involves, killing a person, he's ready to take that risk. Okay, yes, you please stand up. What's your name? Dhruv, stand up, please. Can you just tell me what we read today? This is the end. What happened before that? What two important things happened that day. One was a servant leaving. What was the other thing? That was the second thing that happened. We know the first. What is the first then? The body was alive. What a contradiction. You're saying body and you're saying alive. Oh my God. Are we still over there? What was the first incident that happened this day that we are talking about? Sit down and be attentive in the class. No, you have not told me the whole story. You have not told me the whole story. You just made a fool of yourself. That's it. Yes, over there. That's Prachi. Stand up, please. What was the second strange thing that happened? But yes, so she was quite relieved to know that he had not come to arrest Dr. Sadao. In fact, he had come to take him for the surgery. Then, of course, now here the general has planned something. We have heard a lot about the general, and now we come to know about one thing, that the general he's very concerned about his health, and that is why he does not want to, you know, lose Sadao. And for that purpose, he is ready, you know, like, yes, to kill the man so that Sadao would not be in any danger. So this shows that how much trust the general has in Sadao. And in fact, Sadao is also quite an important person. That is why he did not go with the troops in the first place. Okay, right? Yes, so now Sadao is also quite concerned that I should also get rid of the man so that my family is not in danger. He left the general's presence and then went home thinking over the plan. In this way, the whole thing would be taken out of his hands. He would not have to worry what to do with the man. He would tell Hana nothing, since she would be timid at the idea of assassins in the house. Otherwise, she would not be able to sleep at night. Right? If she would be aware that assassins would be coming to take away the man. So he's decided, I will not tell Hana anything. And yet, such persons were essential in an absolute state such as Japan, where power is there in a few hands. Right? So yes, so it was very important here. How else would rulers deal with those who opposed with them? How would rulers deal with people who opposed with them? Eliminate them. That means, yes, the rulers, they had their private assassins. So the general also had his private assassins, and he is going to help Sadao. Do you think it's right you save a life and then you want that person to be killed? It's right? It is. Why? So once again, we're back to the starting. Then why did Sadao save that man if you wanted him to be killed? So he's doing both his parts as a doctor as well as a citizen. So as a citizen, he's showing his loyalty that I've informed about the American, right? And now the general can do whatever he wants to. Was he himself aware that he would save this man? So he himself was not quite sure that the man would survive.